Pardon? Sorry, Lindsay?
Oh no, it said recording in process.
Oh yeah, but yeah. It can see you, just so you know.
Okay, awesome. Yeah.
Okay, namaskar, namaste, sadnam, ahom atakuyasi, no siyam, maishika siyam. Welcome to Hatha Yoga. Today we'll be warming up the body and getting the energy moving through all layers of the body. So I invite you to start by bringing the soles of your feet together, coming into a Baddha Konasana. So, of course, we're seated on the seat bones. Feel free to sit on a cushion or not, whatever feels right for you. And bring the soles of your feet together. Raise up your chest. Grow tall in the spine. Bring your chin parallel to the ground. Place the hands on either ankle. Press your big toes together. Press your feet together. And at the same time, press the knees down towards the ground. Inhale into your long, tall spine and take a big sigh. Inhale, big sigh. Inhale, big sigh. Inhale here. Exhale, walk your hands forward over the legs. Fold over your legs a little bit. Keep the arms in front of you, but with a slight bend in the elbows, so you're not going to fold all the way down, you're going to be about halfway up, so you have a little bit of strength in the arms and a little bit of give at the same time. Applying the sthira and the sukha, the balance and the effort and the ease all at once. Take a deep breath in and a big sigh. Inhale here. Exhale, walk your hands over to your left and keeping about halfway up still, just move over to the left and then be mindful. See, did that right knee rise up? Press it back down with your muscles down to the ground. Deep breath in. Big sigh. Inhale. Exhale, walk your hands back to center. Take a breath here. Big sigh. Inhale. Exhale, walk your hands over to your right side. Did the left knee float up? Press it back down towards the ground. Deep breath in. Big sigh. Inhale. Big breath out. Inhale here. Exhale, walk your hands back into center. Inhale. Exhale, this time you are gonna fold over the legs. Fold over the legs, maybe placing the elbows on your mat and then letting your head and neck relax. Or folding right over the feet and stacking your hands on your fists and placing your forehead on top of your fists. Breathing here, resting in your Baddha Konasana, butterfly pose, bound angle pose, and folding forward. Listening to your body where you need to let your head relax or let your body settle into the fold. Go as deep as you wish or pull back a little bit and be mindful of your edge. Always let your body guide you in your practice. Take a deep breath in and a big sigh. Inhale, exhale, stretch your arms out in front of you and push yourself back up one little step of the hands at a time. Inhale, placing the hands on the ankles, roll the shoulders away from your ears, pull the chest forward, long, tall spine. Big sigh. Inhale here. Exhale, bring your left foot in and then your right foot in front, finding Sukhasana. Inhale, open your chest, look up. Exhale, tuck your chin in, send the spine behind. Some seated cat-cows. Inhale, open the chest, look up. Exhale, send the back of the heart to the back of your room. Inhale, open your heart. Exhale, open the back of the heart. Gathering energy in the spinal column in Sushumna, raising the Kundalini as you open the heart chakra. We'll spend 30 seconds finding a rhythm here with this movement. Straight spine. Big sigh. Inhale, your arms up above head. Exhale, bring your left hand behind your hip slightly and your right hand to the outside of your left knee. Look over your left shoulder, finding a gentle seated twist. 5 breaths. Inhale, big sigh, tuck your belly button into your spine, inhale, left arm up and right arm up, come to the center. Exhale, place your right hand behind you and your left hand to the outside of the right knee, gaze over your right shoulder, deep breath in, big sigh, 5 breaths here. Inhale, exhale, tuck your belly button into your spine, inhale your right arm up and the left, exhale, place the hands down onto your knees, deep breath in, exhale, plant your hands in front of you, come to hands and knees, finding tabletop position, aligning the knees beneath the hips, the hands beneath the shoulders, the spine is in neutral position, the head is in alignment with the spine, fingers are spread, press the fingertips, pads of the hands, and the heels of the hands into your mat, and the index and thumb create a little triangle as the middle finger points directly forward. Toes are tucked as the knees are beneath the hips, and you're in your tabletop position. From here, you're going to inhale your right arm out. Exhale, bring that right arm, thread it through the left, lower down onto the right shoulder. You can keep your left hand where it is, or you can reach your left hand in front of you. Breathe here, 10 breaths. Deep inhale, exhale, plant that left hand again underneath the left shoulder and push yourself back up, placing both hands underneath the shoulders. Then we'll do 5 cat-cows here. Inhale, hips up, belly drops, chest up, look up. Exhale, send the tailbone under, tuck the belly button in, send the back of the heart up, look between the knees. 4 more, inhale, open the chest, cow pose. Exhale, send the back of the heart up to the sky, cat pose. 3 more, find your rhythm, find your breath. Moving through the whole spine, activating the hips, activating the arms, head and neck. 2 more. And we'll switch sides for our thread the needle. Inhale your left arm out. Exhale, bring that arm underneath the right, lowering down onto that left shoulder. Feel free to inhale your right arm forward or keep it where it is, up to you, wherever you feel most balanced and stable. And breathe here 10 breaths. Deep inhale, big sigh, inhale, exhale, bring that right hand back underneath the shoulders and push yourself up slowly, planting both hands in line with the shoulders, shoulders in line with the wrist. Inhale, look up, gaze up, hips up, belly drops, cow pose. Exhale, spine up, belly tucks, look between the knees, cat pose. Four more, inhale, open heart. Exhale, open back of heart. Inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat pose. Inhale, moo. Exhale, meow. Inhale, open your heart. Exhale, open the back of the heart. Inhale here. Exhale, bring your big toes together. Send your knees wide to the edges of your mat. Bring your seat to meet your heels. Stretch your arms out in front of you. Lower your chest down to your mat. Bring your forehead or chin to your mat, finding child's pose. 10 breaths. Really breathe into the hips, opening and awakening. Find a deep inhale, big sigh, four more breaths just like this. Inhale here, exhale, press into the hands, straighten out the arms, lift the chest, inhale. Exhale, press into the fingertips and pull yourself forward back onto hands and knees. Bring the knees back to neutral beneath the hips. Tuck the toes, plant the hands beneath the shoulders. Neutral spine, tabletop position. And sway to one side and then to the other side. Start to move a little bit laterally, getting into the side waists. Into the obliques and the abdominals. Just a little bit side to side. And then taking a deep breath, pressing into the fingertips, pads of the hands and heels of the hands. Tuck your toes. Inhale, open the chest, hips up. Exhale, send those hips up and back, downward facing dog, pressing into the arms, pressing the chest towards the thighs, looking between the feet, finding downward facing dog, creating this triangle shape with the body. Breathing here. 10 beautiful breaths here. Feel free to pedal your feet as you breathe. Coming up onto your tippy toes, press into your hands, look forward towards your hands. Exhale, start to tippy toe your feet all the way towards your hands, adjusting yourself as you need, maybe stepping the hands a little bit further forward as you bring your toes towards your wrists, keeping the heels lifted. Inhale here, halfway lift, hands on fingertips or on shins. Exhale, plant your fingertips down on your mat and then bring your seat to meet your heels. Your seat has met your heels. Now you're going to leverage your knees down towards the ground, creating a shelf with the thighs, and then straighten out your spine, finding a toe squat. Breathing here. Out to your sides and up above head. Exhale, thumbs to your heart center. Inhale here. Exhale, press into the feet. Lift yourself up, rising up, straightening out the legs. Keep the heels lifted for a moment when you get up to standing straight spine. Inhale. Big sigh. Inhale, arms up. Follow the thumbs with your gaze. Challenge your balance. Exhale, heels root, thumbs come back down to your heart center. Inhale. Exhale, arms out to your sides, toes spread, fingers spread, palms facing forward, chest open, shoulders rolling back and down your spine. Inhale, your arms up and out. Exhale, press the hands out to your sides at a T, straight back, swan dive, fold forward over the legs, Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Bend your knees a fair bit, clasp either elbow, and fold here, bringing the torso along the thighs, letting the head and neck relax, becoming completely folded over, long spine, relaxed head and neck, heavy arms, and a bend in the knees to protect the hamstrings, and maybe slowly, slowly you start to straighten out the legs, but take your time here, 10 breaths. Inhale, exhale, release your hands in front of your toes. Inhale, halfway lift on fingertips or hands on shins. Exhale, plant your hands in front of you, step your feet back, finding a plank pose, bringing the body all in one line, pressing out through the heels, hips up, shoulder blades away from each other, center of the spine rising up, head in line with the spine, body all in one long line. Strong and powerful. 5 breaths in your plank. deep inhale. Exhale, bringing the chest forward over the wrists. Tuck the elbows into the ribs. Chaturanga down in one long line, all the way to the ground. Point your toes behind you. Inhale, low cobra. Exhale, lower down onto your belly. Reach the arms in front of you. Breathe here, five breaths. Deep inhale, big sigh, inhale here. Exhale, plant your hands underneath your shoulders. We're gonna stay here, flat, feet flat, toes pointing behind, legs glued together, creating that cobra tail. And we're gonna do three stages of Bhujangasana cobra pose. So inhale your chest up and breathe in your cobra pose. Five breaths here with the palms on the mat. Just the chest up, and the chin up, the head up, in your baby cobra. Taking a deep breath in. Staying here, exhale, lift your hands off your mat, roll the shoulders back even further, tuck the belly button in, supporting the spine with the core, lifting your chest with the muscles of the back instead of using the arms at all. Five breaths here, floating the hands. Inhale, exhale, plant the hands back down and lower your chest down. Keep the elbows tucked into the ribs. Put the forehead or chin on your mat. Three breaths. Deep breath in, big sigh. Inhale, pressing into the hands, roll the shoulders away from the ears, look forward, gaze forward, chest up, and keeping the elbows bent, come up halfway. 10 breaths here, strengthening the arms and giving the power of your back bent. Exhale, flatten back out, lower your forehead or your chin to your mat, breathe here, three breaths. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, bring your hands forward, maybe about an inch or so. Yeah, that helps for a lot of people to protect the lower back. And spread the fingertips, press into the hands, press into the tops of the feet. Inhale, push yourself up, extend your arms all the way, coming into your full cobra pose. 10 breaths. Open chest, shoulders away from the ears, gaze up, heart opening, spine activating, kundalini energy flowing through your whole body. When mine met yours, it's Big sigh or lion's breath, tongue out, eyes wide. Two more. Inhale. Exhale, walk your hands forward, slowly coming down onto your belly, reaching the arms all the way forward, pressing into the tops of your feet, pressing into your fingertips. Bring your forehead to your mat, pull the spine apart. Grow as tall as you can, pull with the feet, pull with the fingertips, pressing the feet into the ground, pressing the fingertips into the ground. Three breaths here. Deep inhale. Exhale, plant your hands underneath your shoulders, tuck your toes, inhale. Exhale, push your hips up and back into your plank pose. Inhale, plank pose. Exhale, hips up and back, finding your downward facing dog. Deep breath in your downward dog. Exhale, lower your knees down onto your mat. Flatten out the feet again, bring the seat to meet your heels and bring your arms along your sides. Lowering your forehead to your mat, finding a garbhasana or embryo pose. Breathe here. Resetting the spine after those back bends and allowing the cervical spine to correct back to its original state. Now from here, deep inhale. Exhale, bring your arms out in front of you. Inhale, press into the hands. Exhale, lift the chest up, straightening out the arms, lifting the chest off of the thighs. Inhale. Exhale, lift the seat off the heels, tuck your toes, walk your hands back towards your knees. Inhale here. Exhale, lift the knees off the ground, creating that shelf with the thighs again, coming back into our toe stand or toe squat, and breathing here. 10 breaths here, feeling the strength of your legs. Inhale, your arms up. Palms come together above head, bring the thumbs to the heart center. Balance and breathe. Try and keep the heels together in your toe squat. My body's just reminding me. Take a deep breath in. Big sigh. Inhale here. Exhale, plant your hands in front of your knees. Send your seat up halfway and walk your hands forward all the way to come back into your plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga down, elbows tucked in close to the ribs. Inhale, your back bend, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, tuck the toes again, press the hips up and back, downward facing dog. Five breaths here, pedal out the feet again, bend the knees, lengthen the spine, strengthen the arms. And taking a deep breath in, exhale, coming into stillness, send the hips up high, really press into the hands. Inhale, your right leg up, toes pointing towards the ground, hips stay square. Breathe here, five breaths, strengthening your core. Deep inhale, exhale, bring that foot down to meet the left foot. Inhale here, Exhale, press the hips up high. Inhale, left leg rises. Toes point towards the ground, foot is flexed. Keep the hips square. 5 breaths. Deep inhale. Exhale, bring the feet to meet, coming back to your downward facing dog. Inhale, your right leg up. Exhale, bring that foot in between your hands. Lower your back knee down for a low lunge. Inhale, lifting the chest, lifting the heart, and lifting the arms. Finding your low lunge position, strong arms away from the shoulders, palms facing each other. That front knee is above the right ankle. Back toes are tucked. Breathing here, 5 breaths. Reaching for the light and bringing light into your body. You are strong, you are powerful. Inhale. Big sigh. Inhale here. Exhale, plant your hands on either side of that front foot. Straighten out your back leg. Inhale. Exhale, press that back foot down at a 45 degree angle and hips width distance apart. Lift your chest, lift your torso, rise up. Inhale, arms up. Warrior one, sink into that front knee. 5 breaths in warrior one. You are strong, you are powerful. Light pouring in through your fingertips. Inhale, straighten out your front leg. Exhale, fold over that front leg, straight spine, reaching your hands towards the right ankle, folding over that right leg, coming into Parsvottanasana, pyramid pose. Breathe in your pyramid pose. Relax the head and neck. Deep inhale, big sigh, inhale here. Exhale, plant your fingertips down on either side of the right heel. Inhale, lift the chest, straight spine. Exhale, plant the palms down, pivot the back foot, step the feet back, plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Or feel free to take a vinyasa here, chaturanga down. Inhale, your back bend. Exhale, downward dog. Deep breaths in your downward dog. And when you're ready, inhale your left leg up. Exhale, bring that foot in between your hands, setting up for low lunge on the opposite side. Lower the back knee down, making sure that front knee doesn't go past the toes. It's right in line with the heel. Lift the torso, tuck the tailbone under slightly. Inhale the arms up. Palms face each other, reaching for the light. 5 breaths. You hold your crown chakra in your hands. The universe is at your power and will. Inhale. Exhale, plant your fingertips down on either side of that front foot. Straighten out your back leg. Inhale. Exhale, press that right foot down to a 45 degree angle at hips width distance and rebound yourself up all the way to standing with that front knee bent, left leg pointing forward, arms rise up. Deep breath in, big sigh, sink into your warrior one, squaring your hips, feeling your strength. You are strong, you are powerful. 4 more breaths. Inhale, exhale, straightening out that front leg and folding forward over that front leg, bringing your hands over to meet the left ankle and letting your spine curve over that left thigh, bringing the forehead towards your knee or shin, Parsvottanasana, pyramid pose. breathing deeply. Three more breaths here. Inhale. Exhale, plant your fingertips on either side of that left heel, pressing into the fingertips. Inhale, the chest up, straight spine, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the palms again, fingers spread. Pivot that back foot, lifting the heel. Step the left foot to meet, finding plank pose. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga down. Inhale, your back bend. Exhale, up and back, downward facing dog. And we'll hang out in downward dog for five breaths. Feel free to stay in stillness or feel free to pedal the feet. If you really need a child's pose, now's a good time to take one. Find a deep breath in and a big sigh. Inhale your right leg up behind you. Exhale, bring that foot in between your hands, and we're gonna set up for warrior one right away here. Step that back foot down, hips width distance, 45 degree angle, bend the right knee, inhale, rise up. Big breath out. Inhale, straighten that right leg. Exhale, folding forward, bringing your left hand to the outside of your right foot and your right hand up to the sky, coming into a revolved triangle. You can place the left hand on the ankle if you wish, or you can place the fingertips on the outside of the right foot or onto a block. Breathe here. Deep inhale, exhale, pivot that right hand down on the outside of the right foot, left hand on the opposite side, aligning hands underneath the shoulders, bend that front knee, pivot the back foot, step back, plank pose, inhale, exhale, chaturanga down, inhale, your back bend, exhale, up and back, downward facing dog, deep breath in, big sigh, inhale, your left leg up. Exhale, bring that left foot in between your hands, setting up for warrior one on the opposite side. Step that right foot down at a 45 degree angle, hips width distance, press into that left foot, inhale, rise up. Warrior one, deep breath here, big sigh. Inhale, straighten out that left leg. Exhale, fall forward, bringing that right hand out to the outside of your left foot or on top of the left ankle, and inhale the left arm up to the sky, gaze towards the left thumb, finding your revolved triangle. Deep inhale. Exhale, lower that left hand down to the outside of the left foot, right hand on the opposite side, aligning hands to shoulders, bend that front knee. Inhale, pivot that back foot, step back, plank pose. Exhale, chaturanga down. Inhale, your back bend. Exhaling, up and back, downward facing dog. Pedal out your feet. Taking a breath in stillness, send the hips up, press into the hands. And exhale, inhale here. Exhale, walk, step, or hop your feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway lift on fingertips or hands on shins. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, slightly sending the seat down about halfway, keeping the heels rooted. Tuck your belly button in. Inhale, lift the chest, lift the arms, finding Utkatasana, chair pose. Five breaths. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, palms come to your heart center. And breathing here, deep breath in. Exhale, release the hands down to your sides. Palms face forward, finding mountain pose. Spread your toes. Inhale, the arms rise up. Exhale, press the arms out to your side, swan dive forward, straight spine. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Tuck your belly button into your spine. Inhale, rise back up. Palms come together above head. Exhale, finding your mountain pose. Stand strong here. Deep breath in. Big sigh. Inhale, lift your heels, coming up onto your tippy toes. Tuck your tailbone under, roll the shoulders back. Find a tall, straight spine. 5 breaths. Deep inhale. Exhale, bring the palms to your heart center. Finding your balance, slowly bring your seat to meet your heels, making your way back into that toe squat. Inhale, finding your toe squat. Pressing the heels towards each other, breathe. Deep breath in, big sigh. Inhale. Exhale, press your hands to the ground on fingertips on either side of your hips and lower yourself down onto your seat. Inhale, your legs out in front of you, pointing the toes up towards the sky, coming up into the seat, lifting your chest. Big breath out. Inhale, arms up. Navasana, boat pose. 10 breaths. Challenge your core. Smile through it. It makes it easier. Deep inhale, big sigh, 2 more breaths. Inhale here, exhale, plant the feet just in front of you. Bring your elbows on either side of the knees, hug yourself close, tuck your chin in, look down towards your knees. Breathing here. Deep breaths. Inhale, exhale, press the fingertips down on either side of your hips, press into your feet, push your seat up with your fingertips, walk your hands up to bring your seat to meet your heels, finding that toe squat again, creating a shelf with your thighs, inhale, arms up and out, and thumbs to the heart, deep breath here, big sigh. Inhale, rise all the way up to standing. Keep the heels lifted, pressing in towards each other. Finding your strong, tall, powerful, lifted stance. Inhale, and exhale, bend the knees, come back down to your toe squat. We'll go through 4 more. Watch your knees, you can omit this if you have knee issues. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, sink down. Inhale, rise. Exhale, lower the seat. Inhale, rise. Exhale, sink down. Where are we going with this? Who knows? Inhale, rise all the way up. Keep the heels lifted. 5 more breaths, floating the heels. Getting a super calf workout today. Inhale, exhale, press the heels down, send the seat down halfway, arms rise up, chair pose, Utkatasana, 5 breaths. Deep inhale, exhale, folding forward, hands in front of your feet. Inhale, halfway lift on fingertips or hands on shins. Exhale, plant the hands beneath the shoulders, step back, plank pose. Hold in your plank, 5 breaths. Deep inhale. Exhale, send your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Inhale, your right leg up behind you. Exhale, bring that foot to the outside of your right hand. Lower your back knee down. Pressing into your left hand, inhale your right arm up, look towards your right hand. Big breaths in, big breaths out. Two more. Inhale, exhale, plant the hands beneath the shoulders, keeping that right foot where it is. Inhale onto the edge of the right foot, open that right hip. Breathing here, chest open. Five breaths. Deep inhale. Exhale, walk your hands forward a little bit and bend the elbows. See how deep you can go. Listen to your body. Maybe you can make it all the way down onto your elbows. Not a requirement. Do what you can and breathe here 10 breaths wherever you land. This is a great time to do lion's breath and get the frustrations and stuckness out of the hips. And I like to call it dragon's breath when we're in this lizard pose. Deep inhale, exhale, bring your hands one little step at a time back underneath the shoulders. Inhale, straight spine. Exhale, flatten out that right foot again. Inhale, straighten out your left leg. Exhale, step your feet together, finding plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Nope, I lied. Exhale, up and back, downward facing dog. Enjoy that chaturanga if you just did one, and meet in downward facing dog. Deep breath in, big sigh, inhale left leg up, exhale bring that left foot to the outside of your left hand, lower your back knee down, keeping those back toes tucked, or at least I like to for better balance, and finding your twisted lizard. So inhale, pressing into the right hand and lifting the left hand up to the sky, looking towards your left bum. Three strong, powerful breaths. Inhale, exhale, plant the hands beneath your shoulders. Inhale, pressing into that edge of the left foot and opening the left knee. Coming into the dragon pose. Deep breath here, five breaths. Inhale, exhale, walk your hands forward, maybe bending the elbows, maybe coming all the way down onto your elbows. Listen to your body. And find 10 breaths here. Again, feel free to use lion's breath or dragon's breath to burn away the tension. Deep inhale, big sigh, inhale, straighten out the arms as you exhale, walk the hands back underneath your shoulders, inhale, straighten out that right leg, exhale, step the left foot back to meet the right in plank, inhale in your plank, and exhale, chaturanga down to the ground, this time I mean it, and point your toes out behind you. Planting the hands beneath your shoulders, inhale up, full cobra pose, five breaths. Deep inhale, exhale, lower halfway, elbows tucked in close to your ribs, tuck your toes behind, reverse chaturanga, up to plank. Inhale, plank. Exhale, up and back with the hips, downward facing dog. Deep breath here. Big sigh. Inhale. Exhale, bring your knees down to your mat, toes tucked. Send the knees back a little bit further out away from the hips so that we can come into puppy dog or anahatasana, heart melting pose. Deep breath in. Exhale, walk your arms forward until you can bring your chest down onto the ground. If that's not accessible to you, you can put a pillow, a cushion, a stack of blankets, or even a stack of books underneath your chest. So take your time. You have at least a minute to figure out how you can rest here in Anahatasana, coming down onto the chest and chin or forehead. And breathing deeply, feeling your heart open and your arms stretch. Breathing here, 30 more seconds. Inhale, big sigh, inhale, exhale, pressing into the elbows or the hands, rolling in the shoulders and slowly lengthening the arms, lifting the chest up, walking your hands back one little step at a time, hands plant beneath the shoulders, fingers spread, toes are tucked, coming into your tabletop position. Deep breath here, big sigh. Inhale in your tabletop. Exhale, bring your big toes together. Send your knees wide to the edges of your mat. Bring your seat to meet your heels. Stretch the arms forward, coming into child's pose. So we're moving into our cool down now. Hopefully you have some heat in the body. Hopefully you feel the movement through all the limbs. Now taking a deep inhale, exhale, bend your elbows underneath your shoulders and come up onto the elbows, lifting the chest. Lift your seat a little bit, keep your knees where they are, but then bring the inside of your foot, the arch of your foot or the ankle to touch the floor on both sides of your legs, and you're coming into frog pose. Then you can bring your seat back a little bit more, which might be very intense. And we'll be here for 1 minute. So if it's too intense for your hips, walk your elbows further forward. Yep, that is pretty intense. Seconds here. You can do it. Getting into the hips here in the psoas muscles gets rid of old conditioning, frustration, old programs of I'm not enough or I don't have enough, and brings in safety, abundance, a sense of stability and connection to the earth and life itself. Plus, you're being a frog, so it's got to be fun somehow, because frogs are awesome. We're almost there. Deep breath in. Big sigh. Two more. Inhale. Inhale. Inhale here. Exhale. Walk the elbows forward. Keep them walking forward until you bring your pelvis down on the ground. You can point your toes behind or leave the feet sort of like that, and the feet are going to be wide, and you'll bring your elbows underneath the shoulders or just ahead, coming into a wide-legged sphinx, which maybe I just made that up, but that's fine. Yoga is always evolving. Take a deep breath here. Exhale, bring the toes together, gluing the legs together. Inhale. Exhale, walk the arms down in front of you. Flatten yourself out. Pull the chest away from the hips, pardon me, and lengthen your spine, pressing into your fingertips and pressing into the tops of the toes. Lengthen your spine, engage the quads, engage the glutes. Breathe here. 5 breaths, forehead on your mat. Deep inhale. Exhale, plant the hands beneath the shoulders. Tuck your toes. Reverse chaturanga up into plank. Inhale in your plank. Exhale, up and back, downward facing dog. So we're going to have one more opportunity of activating the entire body and using the core. So your feet are going to be parallel to each other at hips width distance. And you're going to bend, send your seat back and then bend your knees so that they float about 3 to 6 inches above your mat. Press into the elbows, press into the palms of the hands and bend your elbows slightly. Look towards the ground, tucking the elbows in towards each other, squeezing all the muscles. Breathe here, 10 breaths if you can. You can do it, you're powerful and strong. Three more breaths. Inhale, exhale, send the hips up, straighten the legs, press the heels towards the ground, coming into downward facing dog. Deep breath in, big sigh. Inhale, lift the heels, coming onto your tippy toes, press into the fingertips. Slowly walk your feet towards your hands. Keeping the heels lifted, come up onto your fingertips. Halfway lift. Exhale, bring your seat to meet your heels. One last toe stand, toe squat. Creating that shelf with the quadriceps. Inhale, arms out and up. Palms come together, thumbs to your heart. 10 breaths here. Heels pressing in towards each other, maybe even if they don't touch, that's fine. Arms up above head. Exhale, bring the hands down in front of you. Send your hips up one more time for a last standing forward fold. Fold over the legs, bend the elbows. Clasp either elbow so that you have some weight with the arms. And relax the head and neck. Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Perhaps bend the knees a fair bit here. Or maybe you're ready to straighten them out. And breathe 10 breaths in your standing forward fold. Last standing posture. Find a deep inhale. Exhale, bring your fingertips down in front of your toes. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bring your seat to meet your heels and walk your hands behind you. Coming down onto a seat, inhale, straighten your legs out in front of you. Relax the feet completely. Straighten out your spine, pull the flesh of your seat out from underneath you and find a long, tall spine and then slowly walk your hands over your legs, folding into one of my favorites, obviously, if you've been to a few of these classes, caterpillar pose. Because every yoga practice is an opportunity to metamorphosize. So relax here. We'll be here for 2 full minutes. And if it's not relaxing, walk yourself back a little bit. Maybe rest on the elbows, place the head in the hands. Or you can put a cushion, a blanket, a jacket stack in between your knees, depending on what you have around you, to give yourself a prop. Deep, slow breaths, working on slowing the breath down, slowing the heart rate down, and sinking into the parasympathetic nervous system rest and digest state as we move towards our final relaxation. Wherever you are, take a deep breath. As you exhale, see if you can soften a little more into the posture for the last 30 seconds. Just sink right in as deep as you can. Deep inhale, exhale, plant your hands in front of you on either side of the feet, and then maybe slowly you walk your hands along the legs, and you're very slowly taking at least a few breaths to walk yourself back up into a straight spine. Inhale your shoulders up to your ears, exhale, roll them back and down. Inhale your shoulders up to your ears. Exhale, roll them back and down. One more time, inhale, shoulders up. Exhale, roll them back and down. Place the fingertips on either side of your hips. Bring your knees in towards your chest. Bring your hands on top of your shins, just underneath the knees. Maybe scoot forward on your mat about halfway and roll yourself onto your back. Also, one of my favorite things you can do in yoga is become a little roly-poly oly ball, a little roly bug, and just massage your whole back with your own body. Massage is free if you roll around on the floor. And actions like these also connect us to our inner child. So roll around, have some fun as we prepare for our second to last posture. Happy baby. Deep inhale. Exhale, coming into stillness on the back, relaxing the shoulders down, relaxing the back of the head down onto the ground, and bring your feet to face the sky. Bring your arms on the insides of your legs, and then clasp the outsides of your feet with your fingers, meaning, of course, you're going to have to bend your knees. Now you can keep your feet kind of halfway there, keep the arms nice and straight, listen to your hips. But what I invite you to do is make sure that you press your sacrum back down towards the ground. There's a tendency to lift the sacrum and float the buttocks off the ground, but you want to press the lumbar and sacrum back into the ground, keeping the lower spine pressed towards the ground. And then you want to open the hips as much as you have space for. So if you can open them really wide, that's awesome. Knees are pointing towards the ground, feet are flexed towards the sky, or you can have them any degree that works for you, even the feet together, the knees out towards the rib cage, whatever works for you to get a bit of a hip opening and a bit of a rest here. Connecting to your inner child, even playing, rocking back and forth, stretching one leg and then the other. And smiling, even if the hips are hurting. Ten more breaths here in your happy baby. Inhale, big sigh, two more, let everything out. Inhale, release the hands, straighten out the legs, and the arms come behind you. Exhale, lower the legs down, point the toes, reach the arms, inhale, stretch long. Exhale, relax the feet, relax the legs. Float the arms down gently to your sides, the palms facing up, the feet relaxing and falling out naturally, thighs and calves relaxing, glutes unclenching, hips and pelvis sinking into the ground, belly relaxing. Breath grows softer and a little bit more shallow. Bring the shoulder blades underneath the heart to lift the chest, getting the full capacity of the lungs. As you sink into your Shavasana, giving yourself time to die away, letting all the old dissolve, and to integrate your practice in order to be born anew at the end of it. Settle in completely, soften fully, relax into the earth. Thank you. slowly you can start to wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes. And slowly, slowly start to make your way back into your body and eventually back up to a seat. No rush, take your time. Maybe bring those knees back into the chest and roll back and forth. Or perhaps you roll onto one side and press into the free hand, lifting yourself back up into a seat. Listen to your body, make your way there. And once you're ready, finding your way into a seat, inhale the arms out and up. Palms come together above head and center them to your chest. And we'll close out our practice with three ohms followed by Shanti, Shanti, Shantihi. Deep breath in, big sigh. Inhale to Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. But three ohms. Deep breath in. Hi. To all our relations, blessed be. Loka samasta sukino bhavantu. May all beings be infinitely happy and free. Thank you for joining me for this practice today. It's happening every day at 9:15 a.m. Well, Monday to Saturday, not on Sundays. You can sign up at saha.earth/workshops. Thanks so much.